Hey everyone, I'm going to take a moment to show you images in HTML. So up until this point, you've only used text and HTML code. And so we're going to learn the coding, how to put an image into our web page. So to start out, we first have to have some images. So in this example, I've got a few different images that I would use for this travel website. So basically, we're going to take this image and we're going to link to it. So we've got all of our HTML pages here, and then as we start to make our pages larger, it helps to use a folder for images. So you can really name it whatever you want as long as you're using proper naming conventions for both the folder and the file. So again, just a reminder, it's all lowercase, no spaces, no special characters. You also have to make sure that your images have a file extension. So for instance, if you're using a JPEG, it should be JPG. And then if you were using a GIF image, it would be a GIF. And then a PNG image would be PNG. So basically, we're going to take our HTML file, which I've already created for you guys. And we've got the code, which the IMG code is basically the image attribute or image tag. And so basically, we can take and add the source attribute. And that basically links to our image. So basically what this is saying is we are going to link to a folder named images, and inside of it is a file named saintaugustine1.jpg. Now when I'm making this link, the entire time I'm looking at my files and making sure I have the same exact folder name here as I do in the code. Same thing with the file name. If you have one letter uppercase, or you have an extra space or something in there that isn't the same, your link won't work. So basically, we can take this now and save it, open it up, and then there's our image. Okay. So by default, just the image tag linking to our file is all we need. As we go a little bit further into HTML, we do need to know a few other attributes. So one of those is the alt attribute. And the alt attribute is basically a description of your picture. And that's basically used by Google as well as by screen readers. So let's say, for instance, Google read this picture, it would cache it based off of whatever your description is. The other thing is if the picture doesn't show up for some reason, maybe you didn't have the link correct, or if, you know, for some reason the link didn't work, it would show up in its place. Also, if they are using a screen reader for whatever reason, it would read this text to them instead of the image. So if you think about people that may have a visual impairment, this would really help them out so that they can visualize what that picture might be. So the alt attribute is definitely something you want to start including in your images as you add them to your page. And another one is the width and the height. So we've got our width. And it is a guessing game at first. Rather than guessing the image size, like I know the width is 800. I have no idea what the height is because I don't have it memorized. So I'm just going to go ahead and type in a number and we'll see what happens. And it distorts my image. And that looks way worse than the original size. So what I would encourage you guys to do is go look back at your image size. Now you could open this up in a program like Photoshop and look at the image size, or a lot of computers nowadays, they give you the dimensions right here. It says 800 by 529, and those are pixel dimensions. So I can type in 529, and now I can open up my page again. It's all the way back here hiding on me. And there's my image showing the normal size. So that'll help you guys out. Obviously, if you guys mess up and maybe you forget to put in that folder name, I do want to show you guys that like it might break, and this is what's going to show up. And so if you see this little box and then it says just your alt attribute, it means that your image link is broken and the link is not correct. So we've got to go back in, add in our folder name, and then we've got our image back. Now if we go back to our files, I've got a page here for Marco Island, and it's inside of a folder. If you start to organize your page more, your linking to images may change. Okay, so let's go to our Marco Island page. And we're going to go ahead and add a picture here. And I don't have the link memorized. So it's marcoisland.jpg. So here we go. We're going to call images.marcoisland.jpg. And this is just like what we did before, right? We're going to go ahead and test it. And it's not going to work. Watch. Let's see if it opens up. It's back here. So it's just a broken image. Okay. And the reason why it's not working is my file structure is different. So look at more pages. And remember with the linking demo, if you've already watched that, just a little refresher for you. Linking into a folder, you just name the folder name and whatever the file is. So for instance, images and Marco Island. But because we have this file inside of a folder, we have to tell that link for the image to go back one directory and then go find the images and then find my Marco Island. So we're gonna just add the dot dot slash right before it. And so dot dot slash just says go back one folder before you go forward looking for your file. And so now we're gonna save it again. Let's pull it up right here and there it is. Okay. One more thing with images. If you're taking our beginning level Web Essentials class, it's highly likely you may have minimal experience in Photoshop. So you do want to basically make sure that you are including an image that is the correct size. So let me go ahead and link to another image. And I'm on the Gatlinburg page now. And we are going to link to the Tennessee JPEG. And obviously I could add in my Alta Tribute after the fact, but just to get our image up so we can take a look at it. Look how big this image is. This is like huge, okay? And that's way too big. Like I can scroll horizontally for like a while. So it's pretty large to view and nobody's gonna wanna see that picture if it's too big. So let's look at the dimensions. It's over 4,000 pixels large. And it is like almost 3,000 pixels high. So that's way too big for the web. It's about 11 megabytes in size. So if you think about viewing things on the web, the person on the other end that looks at your web page, they would have to look at that image after it's loaded, which may take a while to download. So they have to wait for it to download. So to get around that, if you open your image in an image editor like Photoshop, you can go to File, Export. If you're using an older version of Photoshop, you can just go to an option called Save for the Web, which this is the newer version, so they've nested it in the Export menu. And so we're going to go to Save for the Web. And then right here's our pixel dimension. So if we change this to 800 or to a smaller dimension, it changes it considerably. And now I can basically save it. Tennessee small. So now when I go back to my HTML, I can choose Tennessee small. And let's watch and see how big this image is. Much better size, right? So we can actually see it all in the same window. Obviously the measurements are something you can view on your screen. Keep in mind that a lot of people may have something like a laptop or a smaller device, so we don't necessarily want it thousands and thousands of pixels wide because the user does have to download it and it takes a lot longer. So hopefully that helps you guys out. Again, a lot of this has to do with just learning how to make a link path with your images, and if you've got the link correct, your image is going to show up. If it doesn't show up, don't panic. Go through and double check the names of your files and your folders and make sure that you're using the correct link path. If you're having a lot of trouble with linking to images or files, just email your instructor. A lot of the times we can spot those errors and help you guys understand where you're making a mistake. So hopefully that helps you guys out, and we're here to help you guys if you have questions.